Okay, everyone calm their knickers, alright?
That was a good day on Elite Dangerous, I tell you, that was a good day. Every now and again when I hear that, I can actually hear, what was it, the lady that we had in the background. What was her name? What did we call her? Hurdy-gurdy, wasn't it? I kind of missed that voice attack stuff. That was pretty cool, man. Right, I tell you what, I'm just going to calm my knickers down. Because it was very nearly an industrial-sized accident there. And I'll be back in 2 minutes with a fresh drink. Right, back. Have we got a drag race on? No, car 7-6, that's what we're trying to get back. just trying to think what we need to do now then. I suppose we managed to get the forge up on day 3, which is actually pretty good considering where we are. I think tomorrow night we're going to do this upstairs area, get that all kind of sorted. Just trying to think. So we definitely need, oh, I'll tell you what, let's get a new bow before we do anything. Definitely keep these torches. Or less of them up. Let's put it that way. This is just my general bric-a-brac kind of box. So the cobblestone can go in there now. Let's put the organic stuff back. Here's a question on it, and it's going to sound a bit bonkers, but it's a serious question, right? If there's a zombie out there, right, and can it see through the window? can it actually see me? Whereas if I board the window up, it can't, and that affects whether or not it's going to start coming towards me. I know it sounds like a sort of like really basic, well, of course it can see you kind of question, but is it, I mean, legit, does it work on line of sight as well or not? Or and what I'm asking you is not whether or not you think, I mean, has anyone actually tested it? You know, like spawned in a zombie around a corner, gone into stealth mode, it won't come and find you, but the second it can see you, it will. You know what I mean? I'm not talking about what you think work. Oh shit, did I just repair that? Scrap that. Just trying to think now. Let's make one more shiv. Let's recipes, bone shiv, craft. Get rid of that. Throw that down there. Right, okay. So we've got everything we need to go on a scavenge run if need be. We do need to eat, because we're presumably quite hungry. You're right, Kratali. How you doing, mate? So yeah, we're really running low on the food again, aren't we? No eggs or anything. Let's take the bottles with us. It seems mad not to take those out and go and get some fresh water. But then again, I don't really need to, do I? I can just literally go. Definitely a bit broken, that, innit? Oh, shit. Really? Come on now, sir. Recipes. How'd you do that, then? Hang on. Whoa. Okay.
Hello?
That's still throwing me, because I've never done it before. You're right. Hibibigibibi. How you doing, mate? Thank you for the follow, sir. Just trying to think for tomorrow. We should hopefully be at a point where we can make some. Tell you what, let's just very quickly throw in. I can only make charred meat, can't I? We'll go back to the grill. Oh shit, sensed, really? Fuck you, bro. Stay very quiet from. They can see through windows. They can detect you through open windows. Right, okay. So line of sight definitely has a role. Okay. Go back downstairs. What's that, Fortune? You're now in a maximum damage zone. Expect some roof and complete wall failures. Fucking hell, Fortune. If we can just wait it out again. Weird, isn't it? I don't understand why they keep attacking us. Because they can't detect me, so what are they trying to get in for? Is it because of the campfire and, I'm guessing, the torches? I don't seem to have... We need to get that cobblestone wall up really quick, don't we? I can't get down there, Jan. I'm not risking going down there now, dude. We're just going to sit it out tonight. I've got a nice warm coffee, so... So what's actually happening at the moment then, Fortune? I mean, is it, you know, is it one of those things where it's like completely calm until the shit goes down and it hits really, really quick? Or is it actually like just completely chaos out there? Is it like pissing it down with rain and the wind's howling and all that and it's just going to keep getting worse? Or is it like, as they say, that lull before the storm? You should fucking... is there a reason why you can't go now, Fortune? Because you're supposed to be at Grimace's, aren't you? Which is supposed to be a bit safer. Can't you just fucking go now? What's the delay? It's 300 miles away. Fucking hell. How fast does it travel? And it's definitely heading directly at you. You're right, like a boss. Sorry, mate. We're just talking to Fortune, who's like right in the middle of a hurricane, mate. Believe it or not, that slight takes slight precedence. He's sleeping. What the fuck's that got to do with anything? Who's sleeping? Hang on, I'm confused now, Fortune. It travels at 10 miles an hour. Jesus. Frightening, isn't it? I was reading about like all the different sorts. You know, you get tornadoes, cyclones, hurricanes. I didn't quite understand the exact difference between them all, and you know what sort of causes them. So I was reading about that earlier in the week. Pretty scary stuff, Fortune. Well, what do I mean? Oh God, I don't even know. I mean, can't. I don't know. I just don't know how it works. I mean, I suppose life still has to go on, doesn't it? It's not like everybody can just get in the car and just drive 500 miles away and avoid it, is it? It just can't happen. Life is not that simple, is it? I'm not sure, Clavin. I'm hearing a lot of things out there, mate, to be quite honest. I'm just going to stay very, very still tonight, because obviously the more damage we take, the more we then have to repair, so... Your mom left and your roommate left. Do you not think that maybe you need to leave, Fortune, rather than sitting there, mate? Well, why don't you just go now? What is to be gained from sitting there? Don't give a fuck if he's asleep or not. Take a shovel, fucking smash through the door, mate. Honey, I'm home. What the Forge does is make zombies start poking around. They won't attack, not many, just a few. Usually a screamer, they just poke around until angered. Yeah, the Forge is quite some distance away, the Crimson, so the Forge won't be affecting zombie activity here. At least I'm hoping it's not. Maybe you're right. Maybe the Forge is attracting them, so the spawn just happens to be near the house, and as they amble towards the anvil, perhaps they're picking up on the torches and the campfire. That's even worse, isn't it, if it hits at midnight? So just to add to the fucking terror, it's going to be in the middle of the fucking night as well. That's just sucks, man. I don't know how you will fucking put up with that shit. Mind you, it's like you said, that isn't it, like something like 10 years since one hit your area, or the Florida area, is that right? It is Florida, isn't it? Madness, absolutely madness. See, in the UK, it'd give me a really good excuse to build some sort of bomb shelter down in the basement or something, you know what I mean? Which would actually be a game room, maybe. But it would actually be spent, you know, lots of money spent on it, because it would be, you know, for the family's safety. You get all sorts down, you get a pool table down there. Nice little theatre. Well, I didn't realise this, DC. Apparently torches do. I literally, you know, despite the fact I've put over 1,500 fucking hours into the game, and the rest I would have thought. I wasn't aware of it myself, dude, but I think the general consensus in chat today has been that yes, it does, mate. Or at least torches do, should I say. I don't think candles do. So candles are preferable, but of course they don't. They don't give as much illumination, do they? Cyclone Tracy hit Darwin at midnight, Christmas morning. Longest night of your life waiting for the dawn. Jeez. A nuclear bunker for game. It sounds perfect, doesn't it? The scary thing that hit me was like that they were talking about like what happens at certain wind speeds. And the thing that really, I mean, it really made me realise just how bad it is. It is when they started talking about trees getting uprooted. Now... Trees as I know them in the UK, because obviously they're different around the world, right? They are fucking serious business trees. Like, you know, if a car hits a tree, the car's fucked. The tree ain't going nowhere, mate. So how the fuck something can literally pick up a tree and uproot it or blow it over? That is just fucking frightening. I mean, we're not talking about branches falling off. We're actually talking about trees literally being uprooted. That is just power like I can't even begin to imagine. I mean, I've never experienced anything like that in my life, be it a hurricane or I've experienced a flood, but that was just purely damage. There was no risk. It just meant the water got into the house. You know, no one was in any danger of being swept away in a fucking river or anything like that. It's really quite incomprehensible to people who live in certain areas of the UK. I mean, there are certain areas of the UK, for example, that flood regularly, and that actually is extremely terrifying, and very strong currents and what have you. It's not just about the damage to property and what have you, and the inconvenience. So I wouldn't put everyone in the UK in the same boat, but certainly most people, I would say, that live in, you know, primarily sort of the bigger cities, we've got no way to sort of really relate to what it all means. It's pretty weird. I was watching some footage of like palm trees blowing in the wind during a hurricane, and actually watching them literally just fucking take off. I mean, just scary, man. Absolutely frightening. Seeing an oak with a 1 meter wide trunk get uprooted by a hurricane. Jesus. See, in the UK, right? Nothing is taking down a 1 meter thick tree trunk oak tree, mate. Nothing. Including the people that are actually trying to get rid of it because it's in the middle of their garden. You know what I mean? Just nothing. What's this Twitter link? Is it the Twitter link, Fortune? Ryan Shields. Orlando. Hurricane Matthew. What? Why is the big arrow going towards or from Orlando to the hurricane? Surely not the direction it's going, right? Right, it's fucking huge, isn't it? It's absolutely massive. God damn it. Be where you need to be by 5 p.m. and then stay. The core of Matthew is... Oh, the core is 300 miles away. The outer bounds, much closer. Major damage is likely along our coast with significant damage inland. Worse than Charlie. Fucking hell, for. I'm going to keep that Twitter up, actually. Oh, Fortune, seriously, what the fuck was that picture you posted yesterday in Discord? I'm assuming that was not, like, sort of fiddled about with, right? You know, the Grinch thing. What the fuck, mate? That is, like, one of the scariest ass things I've ever seen. They got through my door. They smashed my door, look. I did a double take on it, Fortune. I was thinking, like, oh, God, that is some, like, nice bit of photoshopping there. And then I started thinking, hang on a minute. Maybe it fucking isn't. I mean, that's a portent of things to come, right? Jesus Christ. Everything's looking good. Everything's looking good. Right. Actually, I'll tell you what I could do. Oh, no. No. I was going to place that landline block down. okay, let's go and check the... Came out the wrong door, didn't I? In fact, actually, I'll tell you what. Before we head today, let's go sort the other door out.
Hello?
Oh, we've done the other door. Oh. Maybe it's all done. You're right. Yeah, Bunner. How you doing? Thank you very much for the follow, mate. How you doing? That was Matthew that was captured by NASA. Yeah, the guy doing the weather freaked out. Not a surprise, Fortune. That is really scary, isn't it? I mean, that's proper fucking bullshittery at work, that is. Well, I honestly really hope everyone's all right, not just you, mate. So who's going to be in the house then? Grimace and his dad? I mean, I don't know. Does it work? It's not like neighbours that have got like a super stage show where you can all go and spend the evening in, or I don't know, mate. I mean, or is it literally everyone just stays in their own house to the fucking best? You're right, Firestorm, thanks for the follow, mate. And there's a portent as well, a Firestorm. Dun, dun, dun. Right, Shelby, please, you got crushed it. I was looking at the pictures on him.
Grum, fix your mic. You're echoing. Time to hit the magic switch.
There we go. Are we back? Are we back yet? Is it fixed yet? 19. Yeah, when I was reading it, there was only two. So they said there would be far more. You know, as they start to get a gauge on. Oh, what the fuck? Is that me? Dude, really? That is annoying as hell. That is really, really annoying, bro. Why so many arrows to kill you? Asshat. I think I turned it on, did I? So we're gonna bubble that up. I'm actually gonna make a cooking grill, which I can't make apparently for some reason. Oh, you need the anvil, that's why. Craft the anvil. We'll go for some iron arrowheads. Let's make 150. Is that all I can make? Oh shit, that's probably not a good idea though. Let's make 50 of those. Needs the anvil. Surprise, surprise. I think we had a good loot last time we played it, didn't we? Before we even set base, I think we'd actually found an anvil and some cooking grills and all that kind of jazz. It's why we're that little bit further behind. God damn it. We need to restart planting. I don't like these things. Restart planting trees as well. There's no point in worrying about doing any of this at the moment. We just need to get the iron. I'm going to have to do an anvil before anything, aren't I? And then once that's done, worry about the forged steel and what have you. Let's take this little bit of iron out and throw that in. No, no point. Let's go home. Cheers, folks. Good to know. Cobblestone walls. We'll go and do something else. It's a tough call, isn't it? It really is. I'm almost tempted to leave this and not bother with what we were doing over here, you know, guys, to be fair. All I need to do is just knock out the bottom rung, really. You know, it's not a problem, is it? What's that, Merman? DDoS, what's that, dude? No, well, they are... They're basically like they always used to be, Elegon. So imagine, like, pre-Alpha 15. So the wooden spikes are basically... They slow them down. They also cause a hell of a lot of damage. But... They cost 100 wood now, dude. So one spike is 100 wood. So incredibly expensive and very slow to manufacture compared to what they used to be. But they absolutely murder zombies in that sense. Very viable tactic still. In fact, it's actually something I was going to do just to have a few spikes in the old backpack just for dogs and things. Right, okay. Beans... And the snowballs can go back in there. I think I was actually making murky water instead of boiled water. So let's boil that up. On. Cook. 1 minute 42. Excellent. So what am I actually going to do then? Food is a massive problem, guys. Food is a massive, massive problem. This dehydrates me. I mean, water's not so much of an issue. Should have done this last night, but I didn't want to risk the zombies actually getting in again. Oh, I didn't see them there. Damn. Well, let's switch that out with that. It's easier to get at. Okay. Okay. I would definitely want to put some spikes just around there. It will certainly help. Should we just start focusing on getting the rock and the cobblestone together for the perimeter wall? Yeah, I'm just trying to starve off imminent starvation. That was all strike. I'd just keep the water for the, you know, I mean, it's, yeah, swings and roundabouts, isn't it? Yeah, we started the first thing earlier on, Shelby. B105 dropped, so, which is basically, it's actually considered the Alpha 50 stable. So, we're kind of sticking with this for a bit. Let's scrap that. Give a Z. Definitely hear one pounding on something, isn't he? Shit, oh, I left the door open. Has he gone in? Oh, no, there he is, look. It's Bob. Hello, Bob. What to do, guys? What to do? Everything's going very slowly at the minute, isn't it? It's like we've got this mad race on to get to where we were. Now we're kind of there. So, yeah, I mean, that forge, I reckon, is far enough away from where we are. I could even argue I put it a little bit too far. Are you all right, Simpsy? How you doing, Simpsy? Yeah, yeah. All right, good. Stay there. Don't move. You're on shift. Oh, I'm going to sneeze. Oh, yeah. That's better. God, blimey. Okay, let's get the grill. Let's make ourselves 50 arrows. Let's make ourselves the grill. Craft that. Brilliant. Not interested in that glass pane. Not interested in the lead. So, after that, we want to make as much forged iron as we can. Or should we just go straight to steel? Is there anything to be gained out of going forged iron then steel? I mean, could I afford steel smithing? Let's have a quick look at the skills. I want to make sure there was no naughty people around. Steel smithing. It's locked. I need construction tools at 40, right? Oh, no. Is that what it's telling me? I need to get construction tools up. And construction tools at the moment is at 8. Holy fuck. That's terrible, mate. So we definitely need to go forged iron first. Let's favorite that. Favorite that. It's 20 per item, isn't it? So if I... Oh, God, is that all I can make?
Hello?
52. That's better. All right, Ms. Taco. Thank you very much for the follow. Tell you what, let's go and get some plant fiber because we're going to need loads of that for the cobblestone, aren't we? So let's go and do this. Get it out of the way. Keep an eye open for, have I still got a broken leg? What the fuck? Look for bird's nests while we're doing it. Alright, Lukey Rowe. Well, that's what I'm thinking, Stripe. It seems weird, doesn't it, mate? I'm starting to think we should have just stayed with the original game. Because it's just, we're not getting any. I mean, this is a brand new server. I mean, so, you know, on the brand new build. So I can only think it's because I've not got enough skill, maybe? I don't know, mate. Well, we've done everything we can to enable that. I did get some nitrate once, I'm sure I did, because I can't think how else I'd get that little stack of four that's downstairs at the house. So I've definitely got nitrate from somewhere, and I can't, if you like, remember looting it from anywhere, so. Yeah, well, you can only go to level 100 now as well, Ares, so because of the extreme expense of some of the skills, like steelsmithing potentially costing you up to 30 points, you're very much more limited. I did actually read a post from Mike Mould from yesterday, actually on the Alpha 15 final release notes, where he said they are looking at actually really making it, so in terms of community play, you do need to specialise. No one's going to be able to be a jack of all trades. That's the direction they want to take the game. So it's not a case of it's not working or it's broken or they've not taken it into consideration. That's actually where they want the game to end up. Thank you for the follow, BT1748. How you doing, mate? When will I get a sub button? Never. Just the end of story, mate. That Fortnite track came out of one of the cupboards. Oh, did it? Ah, in which case, I don't know then, mate. I mean, you tell me, Stripe. You're telling me you're getting it, and I ain't seen nothing, dude. I mean, the server, as we can see, is on 105. I'm on 105. We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Because your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to. Place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world. We look your one far behind. How you doing, Mario? How's things, buddy? What have you been up to? Oh shit, there is a lass there, look. Nice, that'll do us. Won't say no to a little extra paracetamol there. Oh shit, I can hear one. Oh, dang, lady. A ding dang do. A ding dang do. That was fucking close, wasn't it? Jesus. Cheeky monkey. Right, let's go and see if we can get an iron pickaxe off the forge. Oh, I'm not after nitrate. No, I'm not after it, so I'm not worried about digging it up or anything at this point in the game. We're just inquiring as to why we're not seeing any of the fancy pants things. Oh, hang on, I just got rid of the stone axe, didn't I? Claw hammer, can we make one of those? Claw hammer, craft. Pickaxe. Excuse me. That's going to be me mullered for a bit, isn't it? Let's make some more. Don't get it. I went to favourites, look. Okay, fair enough. 30 of those. Okay, I'm going to scrap those. Scrap that. Shit. Oh yeah, we need loads more, don't we? What should I do in the meantime? Play? Oh yeah, there's a deer there. I'm really, really, my mind is whirring, as you can probably tell. I'm really, really unfocused right now. I'm not entirely sure what I want to be doing next. Because obviously we do want to hit some of the, we do want to go on a bit of a scavenge run. We have got... Really? Listening out. Yeah, we have got some iron arrows now. We've got a light source with the torches. We can actually go and hit, well, I suppose the easternmost city, maybe. I mean, the other one's no use to us because there's no shops there, so it's just pointless. That's weird. And drop the stinky feed off. You've had a quite lazy day. Well, that sounds nice, mate. Yes, I know it's a shovel. Gotcha. Right, we've got the claw hammer. Let's go and get the grill up and running. Throw that bad boy. Oh, that's not where it goes, is it? Damn! what the fuck's going to happen now? Oops, can I take that out? Thank you, sir. I'm going to have to stop all these, aren't I? I'd have to stop all production to get that in there. Oh, well, never mind. We can do it later, can't we? Animal fat, rotting flesh, you name it, we've got it. How much longer till I get my pickaxe? Come on. Come on, son! Places to go, people to see, dude. Fucking fannying about like this. Yeah, I just don't know what to do. I literally have no idea. We're going to get the pickaxe. I suppose I can run back and then get the forged iron for the fire axe as well. Well, the thing with the farm beast, I literally have got... This is what I'm saying. I'm not sure whether to just say, okay, let's head out with a little bit of food and sort of, you know, spend the evenings in other places and try and get things like corn and potatoes and come back and establish a farm. Or should we start working on the perimeter fence? You know, I mean, oh, God, what? Jesus Christ, you see that twig nearly had me then, that did. He's still alive. It's that point in the game where you've got to make a decision about which way you're going to go. I mean, do we start working on defenses and just, you know, working on our character? Or do we actually start looking for schematics? And I'm being honest, I really don't know. I mean, there's things that I'd like to do, but, you know, we've done a lot of things 1,000 times over. I might, you know, want to do something a bit different. I just don't know for right now. Let's make the iron. Why can't I make an iron fire axe? What the fuck? I've actually picked it up, right? Yeah. Iron fire axe. Telling me I'm out of wood, aren't you? I know that's what it's telling me. Stone axe, for fuck's sake, mate. And I've got no wood to get the stone axe, right? I just... You couldn't make this fucking shit up, could you? I used it all on the campfire, didn't I? Bloody hell. So I think I'm going to keep that favourited for a little bit. Come on, hurry the fuck up, bro. I so wish I could juggle stuff in this crafting menu. I think Cody's stuck at the top of the stairs. He is, isn't he? Can you hear him? I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll go sit on Simpson's chair. I'll quickly make a mad dash to save the dog. We so better not fucking die. Are you a happy pup now? Are you a happy pup? Yeah. Daddy Grum saved you, didn't he? He's all excited. He wants a big cuddle now. Oh, you little fluffy belly. Right. What do we have to... Oh, you still have to cuddles, mate. Oh. Scrap that. One-handed at a minute, boys and girls. Shall we spend... Oh, mate, you're proper bubbly now, ain't you? What's the matter, fella? Oh, you think you were stuck forever? Get you, mate. We get you. Okay, let's go. What am I after? Should we do what you're saying then, Fortune? I'll tell you what, let's do it then. Let's make a load of cobblestone, then tomorrow morning we'll hit the city, yeah? What about that? So cobblestone frames. How many can I make? 2, because we've only got 10 wood. Need the fire axe, don't we? Should we spend a little bit of time just smashing it? I suppose what we could do, we could get the raw materials now, couldn't we? I need 20 wood. Get the raw materials now. Tonight we can make the cobblestone. That'll do that thing there, won't it? Iron fire axe craft and favourite. So it's going to take me 3 minutes. So while we wait, let's get some wood. What else do I need? I'm going to need wood, clay and stone. And plant fibre, right? So the problem is we're on a server, so if we've all started in the same location, because some people are working together, they're going to find it a lot easier to have someone out scavenging. So by the time I get to the shops, I'm going to be shit out of luck, aren't I? That is sort of the downside of opening the server up on day one for me. We're going to be, we could end up seriously behind the game. But there's not a lot I can do about that at the moment. What's that? Sorry? Alright. I wonder what you meant there, Daddy D. You know, I was like, what? How does he get stuck up there? Because he's too little. He can't get down the stairs. The stairs are too big for him. So if he goes down just like one step, he basically rolls all the way down to the bottom of the stairs, which is quite a long way. So he goes all the way up there. He can clamber up. He can do like a little bum shuffle to get up each step. But then once he's up there, he's fucked. Oh, yeah, the Z then. One minute 30 to make that. That's shocking, isn't it? So hang on, let's have a quick look at what we actually need then. Cobblestone rocks is obviously going to be clay and stone. So I still need to make a shovel as well and a cobblestone frame. So I mean, we could make 192 of those, but that's all my wood gone. But to be honest, fuck it, let's do it. Even if we just get like one, you know, a two high wall would more than do me. But of course, we also get the benefits of construction tools going up, don't we, if we use them, so... Yeah, we'll have to demand payment in schematics because we're going to like be fucked. We're going to be like, everyone will just be out scavenging the shit out of everything while other people are at home creating bases and in fact, we could do with people letting us know where they've looted so I'm not spending hours roaming around without a mini bite trying to get resources only to find out it's already been pillaged. I suppose that's the beauty of it, that people that are watching me play when they're on the surface, they know where I've been, so... Don't have to waste their time, do they? Alright, have we got that fucking axe yet? Here we go, look. Scrap that. Get that. That's a bit more chunky, innit? Much better, mate. Oh, that's risking it for a biscuit, bro. Oh, careful, sir. Long way down. At least we've not got a broken leg anymore. Right, Galax. You can't get any cables. There are no cables, Venator. I'm obsessive about not having cables accessible. You need an hour of sleep. We've only got 2 hours last night. Then I'm packing the head out. Tell them to get the F away from your area. Who's in my area? Oh, right. Oh, I see what you mean, Fortune. Sorry, got you. Yeah, keep in touch if you can, Four. Obviously, good luck, mate. Stay safe. All my love to Grimace and folks as well. I hope it just veers off and misses you, mate. I have a horrible feeling that probably won't happen, but let's hope it doesn't get any closer than it absolutely fucking has to, mate. I have got chat open. Yeah, obviously, every spare minute that I'm not looking at the screen, I'm looking at the Twitch chat though, guys. There's absolutely no point in trying to communicate with me in-game chat, because it doesn't stay up for long enough, and I will miss it, so... Can you make a garden? Yes, you can. Absolutely, mate. In fact, that's probably what we'll be heading out doing shortly, if we can start getting some proper seeds and stuff together. Oh, fuck. Okay, I really need to make a shovel. Oh, whoa. Bird's nest right beyond there. Let's have a look how much we've got. 30. So I can definitely make a shovel, can't I? Iron shovel, favourite craft. So let's have a look at the wood situation. Wood's only at 455. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to travel a little bit away from home. 24 and 22 on the food front. That's really bad, guys. That's really fucking bad. And chop the shit out of these trees. Humping it for dominance. He's got to have his knackers cut off in November. Not sure that's a good thing. Do people still do that? Actually, that's a good question. Because I know in the vets thing it said that he's supposed to come back in November to have his balls lopped off. I remember laughing at the girlfriend saying, well, that's a nice start to the family, isn't it? Welcome to the family. You're about to have your testicles removed. I mean, it seems, I don't know if I could do that to a dog. I didn't with any of my other dogs, but I was a lot younger back then, so I didn't really do a lot other than love the dog. I didn't really pay a lot of attention to what could or couldn't happen. I mean, are the benefits to having a dog mutilated in that way? I mean, is that what people do, or is it something that people don't do anymore? I just don't know. I mean, I know there's things that I grossly fucking disagree with. Like, I mean, there's certain breeds of dog, aren't there, where they actually have like tails and things removed, or they have those ridiculous haircuts and all that kind of jazz. I think it's just fucking ridiculous, but you know, whatever. But what about having a dog's bollocks locked up and stuff? Don't sound very fucking pleasant to me, that. we were just harassing you, Grummy. What's that, blind? What's that, dude? Oh, I must have missed that. A dog that get... Oh, is it called spading them? Gets more mellow. Oh, fucking, if he got any more mellow, mate, he wouldn't be awake ever. I mean, he's the most chill dog I've ever, ever fucking known. And that's not just me saying it because he's our dog. Part of our family. He really is. I mean, he just literally just flops about. He loves sitting up in front of the fireplace. He's going to get a shot when we start turning it on, I tell you. Having a dog spaded or neutered does have benefits, really. Not for the dog though, right? Poor little bastard. I don't know if I can put him through that. Male dogs won't roam or want to escape as much. Ah, right, I know, that's interesting. You're right, fix it. I think we're on one below max at the moment on the server, fix it. A Doberman will bleed out if its tail breaks. That's why a lot of dogs get their tails removed. I didn't think Dobermans had tails. Or is that why? That's actually what they do. They remove... Yeah, but that's a bit weird, don't I? I don't get that, mate. I'm sorry, but I don't get that, Stagger. What are the chances of a fucking Doberman's dog... A Doberman's dog's tails getting fucking lopped off, mate? You can say the same thing about its legs or its head, couldn't you? I don't really get that. I mean, how many dogs lose their tails through natural accidents? Not a fucking lot, I would garner. So I'm not sure if I understand that. If they are fixed early enough, they also won't try to mark the house up to ward off other dogs. He doesn't do any of that, but then again, he is only a puppy, you see, so maybe we've got the joys of that to come. Damn, I could have done without that punch in the nuts there, to be honest. I'm just going to use a quick bandage. I think I'll nip back and get some food as well, actually. Start keeping a better eye out, don't I? Should really go like tree rock, tree rock, tree rock, just to keep your furnace happy. I suppose now might be a point, or rather a reason to start thinking about minus 69, all right? But pop a point in it. Why not? Why not, geezer? Why not? It'd be nice if, you know what I just thought? It'd be nice if trees, if you didn't muller them all the way down, as in destroy them, it'd be nice if they kind of slowly healed. You know, as if they're continuing to grow, so you sort of like, you know, maybe we just like chop a few branches off the top. So if a Doberman's tail gets broken, they have like internal bleeding that can't be stopped or something. That's awful. That's awful. That's really horrible. So that's why they have to have them removed, because it's like a high likelihood that any sort of damage to it could cause it, you know, pretty catastrophic injuries. That's awful. See, that makes sense then, you see? I mean, that seems like a good thing. I'm sure there's breeds of dogs that have their tails removed for aesthetic purposes, though. I mean, I wasn't actually thinking of Dobermans, to be honest. Dobermans are what these hellhounds in games look like, right? Aren't they sort of based on a Doberman dog? Oh shit, hang on a sec, my OneDrive just popped up on my chat screen. 4:04. Resource gathering like a mofo, mate. You wait too long, it can turn cross when neutered. Well, that's what the vet had said. It kind of got like a timeline for all the injections, and it was sort of strongly recommending if you're going to go down that route, you need to do it as early as you sort of can, really. Dogs can break their tails relatively easily, but certain breeds are in danger of major arteries being severed if their tail breaks. Not at all similar to break. Oh god, that's awful, isn't it? I suppose they can get caught in doors and things, can't they, I should imagine? Or just general playing and rolling around. Yeah, I can see that, I suppose. Yeah, I mean, yeah, you wouldn't forgive yourself, would you? I mean, if it's a known concern with a breed that, you know, the dog's a very delicate part and can lead to serious injury if it was to get damaged, then I suppose you're doing it for all the right reasons, aren't you?
Hello?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. You came by shutting it in a door, yeah? Yeah, absolutely. You're right, Mickey Pack. How you doing, mate? I mean, I caught Cody's front paw. I mean, accidents do happen. We've got like a really big fire door that leads out onto the Integral garage. And we did keep him out there when we were out and about. And of course, he was so excited. He used to come up the two steps. And there's like a little landing on the top step where the door opens onto. And of course, he was so excited to hear us back in the house. But he stood there, and of course I opened the door and I heard this yelp, and I'd actually caught his, if you like, his paw between like the surface of the top step and the actual bottom of the door, and he sort of hobbled around for a couple of hours, and then he seemed to shake it off, sort of thing. But we did take him to the vet. Apparently it was just like badly bruised. That was my fault. Well, I suppose it's, accidents do happen, don't they? I had a Z then. I thought I heard a putty cat. Hello, Dread. How you doing, mate? I heard you ended up in hospital, Dread. In San Diego, mate. What? Did you still have a cool time, dude? Was it everything you thought it would be, Dread? I saw loads of Chris's pictures on Twitter, mate. It looked like you were having a wicked time. Have you only just got back, Dread? Did you have like a holiday after as well, then? That's sweet, mate. You're right, Raphius. I bet you got some tales to tell it, you dread. Right, come on. Where are we? Half five. We get in there. We get in there. Some nails? How we doing on... 192 cobblestone frames, so that's good. Let's cobblestone rocks. I'm guessing we're short on clay. I just can't keep up with stone. We need a better way to get stone, guys. I reckon I'm gonna put another point in minus 69er. No chance. I need mining tools up. See what I do need to do. I need to get rid of that because it throws me. It's better. You had some sort of an infection. Oh, you only got back an hour ago. Holy fuck, mate. You back at work tomorrow, dude? Or you got the rest of the week off? They gave me some hydrocodone. So you basically spent TwitchCon high as a fucking kite on painkillers and shit, mate, right? All worked out all right then, did it, Dread? Brucey bonus, mate. Brucey bonus. I take it you had some sort of health insurance then, mate. Because I should imagine over there, walking in and getting something like that would probably cost you several hundred fucking quid, wouldn't it? Nice one, Dread. Nice one. Four's in Florida, mate. Like, bang, slap, where Hurricane fucking Michael's about to hit, dude. So, it's all kicking off, mate. Pretty scary times, man. Okay, where's my home? I think what we'll do is we'll head back, make another pickaxe or two. Try and keep that forge burning constantly, because obviously one of the things we can do a lot is we can scrap that and get a shitload of iron out of it, throw it back in the forge. Really do need to start thinking about scavenging though. So that's a power deposit to be seen. Jeez. Yeah, I think when we went to... where was it? Like an A&E in... I'm trying to think whether... I'm sure it was Portugal, but I'm just starting to think it might have been Spain, actually. And we had to put... I think we had to pay 100 quid. We claimed it back. I'm not sure whether we actually got it back or not. Yeah, it's you can't even imagine it, can you, Dread? It's just really fucking weird, isn't it, mate? It's like yeah, it's frightening, isn't it? I mean, imagine like fucking having like a really bad injury and just knowing you can't afford to have it fucking fixed or seen to. I mean, it's just shocking, isn't it, dude? But I suppose when you think about it, it's not shocking. That money has to come from fucking somewhere, doesn't it? I mean, you know, the NHS is a marvelous, marvelous thing, but it also gets blatantly abused. You know, we all cough up a lot of money to sort of pay into the NHS, I suppose. But yeah, it's fucking frightening. It's hard to imagine like living like that. You know, can't afford to go and see the doctor. I tell you what, at least in this country, mate, it would stop people going to the doctors every time they've got a fucking sniffle or a fucking cold, though, wouldn't it? You know, you might actually be able to see a doctor when you need to fucking see one. I think there's a bit of a middle ground there, to be honest. That might be better on both sides of the water. Oh, that don't sound good. Where are you? Sounds like they're inside. Which means I left the door open again. Did I? Okay. What the fuck? They're not upstairs, are they? Where is it? That is so weird. That's completely thrown me. Like it's all gone quiet now. I bet he's in my fucking bed. Oh, there he is. He's going out the back door, little bastard. He's trying to rob my house. Bloody burglar, look. There you go, matey. That'll teach me to leave the doors open. Well, having said that, I might stop them actually damaging my walls if they just walk through. Oh shit, that was a bad shot, bro. Oi! Get in my fucking door alone, mate! I'm out of arrows. Okay, this is not going very well, is it? Shit. Oh, what? Really? Fucking hell, bro. Arrows. Where the hell are my arrows? Oh, please now. Come on. Fucking missed. Jesus. It's all gone Pete Tong now, mate. Oh, giddy art. Look at this. There we go. Gotcha. Gotcha, punk. Right, okay. Ooh, what happened then? Oh, someone left the game or joined the game. Let's go and grab our iron. Totally agree, Grumbul. I prefer that to wondering if you can afford. Yeah. It does make you wonder, doesn't it? I'd love to know how it works in reality, you know what I mean? I mean, it is a question for you, right? I mean, let's look at this from a realistic point of view, right? You get hit by a fucking car, right? So you've just been hit by a motor. Forget whether it's your fault. That doesn't come into the equation, right? You've been hit by a car. Car's fucked off. All right, so you're left in the middle of the road and you have basically got a bone in your leg sticking out of the skin and there's blood pissing out everywhere, right? So you can't fucking move. What happens in America? Let's assume you haven't got any sort of medical insurance whatsoever, but you've got a job. You just don't have any medical insurance. What actually happens from that point of fucking injury? Someone tell me. It's a fucking mystery to me, mate. It's a fucking mystery. So you've got, say, £1,000 of savings. Do you need any more information than that to answer the question? Let me start putting everything away and then be back with you. You're in Germany, you go to the doctor, you don't pay shit, just €5 towards. Yeah, the same way it works in the UK, mate. You just in the UK, you can get exemptions from the actual cost of the prescriptions. But most folks probably have to pay that. But there's a maximum amount. It's like about £7.50, £8, something like that. Okay, let's get everything put away. I tell you what, I never did. That was a bad mistake, wasn't it? I never made the iron arrowheads look. That was a really stupid move. It's actually 8 o'clock. I'm just gonna make a really quick dash. Quick mad dash back. Is it the southern side where the forge is? It is, isn't it? Yeah. I'm just gonna throw this iron in the forge and then get it bubbling over evening as well. Sorry, what's that? Yeah, I was very surprised when I heard about Jersey, to be honest, Simpsy. It's, I just assumed it was the same. £40. See, that would stop people from going with the sniffs and all that shit, wouldn't it? It really would. If people knew they had to fork out 40, it's a bit more like going to the dentist, isn't it? A bit of a barrier to entry. So you'd only go if you knew that, you know, you were actually legit poorly. I think a lot of people go to the doctor just to get a fucking sick note, to be quite honest. They should have to pay for them fuckers. They have to see you, but you're financially screwed. So an ambulance would, for example, be called and you'd be taken to the hospital and they'd set your leg and sort you out and all that kind of jazz, yeah? But then afterwards, they're going to say, right, that cost you £10,000. So fuck it, take the leg, mate. Fucking Jesus Christ, that is fucking hardcore, isn't it? So basically, they will see you. You're not going to die. But you might be paying that off for the rest of your life. So surely lots and lots of people die in debt to the hospitals then, surely. Holy crap, Zunin. So they can actually deduct payments direct from your bank account. Or sorry, before it even hits your bank account, they actually deduct it directly from your pay slip. Holy crap, dude. So it's not like, there really is like no getting out of it then, yeah? It's like sneaking out the back of the hospital. Side Mickey Mouse. It's not going to happen, no? Fuck. Crazy, mate. It's a fucking crazy world out there, I tell you, boss. Fucking crazy, mate. Actually, I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's take that. Let's ditch that. Let's take... We're actually going to make cobblestone, weren't we? So... Let's put off of this shit, guys. Pickaxe was the next thing to make, wasn't it? There we go. So we've got 192 cobblestone blocks as such. What we haven't got is any cobblestone. Only 12 blocks worth. So I need more clay. I need clay and stone, basically. I think I'll repair that. And food. Basically, food is a big problem. Let's make 10 grilled steaks. Charred meat, grilled meat. Let's eat this crap. The hospitals will still treat you... sorry, what was that? Even if you don't have insurance, they're unable to turn you away, so I got that far. I believe you'll call a broken bone piece and the skin a compound fracture. Sounds about right. All dental health care is private, no help from social... I think you have to pretty much pay in the UK as well, don't you? But isn't it something like £40, depending on what... You have to pay something depending on what sort of treatment you have, from what I understand. I know doctors make a lot of money on night shifts from doing death certificates. I know that's a rather golden little chestnut for them. There are so many people without health insurance. An ambulance in New York City costs $2,000 to $3,000, even if you're just a few blocks away. That's why most people just call a cab. Fucking hell. Jesus God. Fucking don't even bear thinking about it, mate. It really don't. Fuck. Are people more careful in America? do people just pay more attention to what they're fucking doing as well, just to make sure they don't get fucking hurt? Jesus. What about for kids? Do like kids get some sort of exemption or fucking discounted rate? I mean, kids have accidents, don't they? I mean, it's going to happen. You can't have fucking kids lying on the fucking street, surely, like... With mom and dad's giving them a clip round the back of the head while their legs and arms are hanging off from a fucking car accident, and then they get slapped by mom and dad because it's going to cost them a fortune. It's a fucking hell, man. That's just crazy. I can't even begin to understand it, but... Make some bottled water. Then we'll make some rod tea as well. Let's get rid of this tallow, actually. That's just taking up room, isn't it? Tallow. Ooh, shit. Careful. Hang on. I have actually closed the doors, right? Just in case. Go up here and have a think, we'll have a drink. Oh, actually, we can smash this door down now, can't we? Oh, when we finally get our axe back. If a hospital provides $10,000 worth of services to a patient and bills their insurance for that amount, they will get paid about $3,000 to $6,000. Bloody hell. Kids don't get any special treatment. Fucking hell, that's shocking. So it's the insurance companies that are, it's big business, isn't it? It's big business. Kids can have medic aid if household income is below a certain level. Every state has different requirements. No, I don't want out like that. Thank you, Crimes. I don't operate like that, mate. I'm a self-sufficient little man in this game, but thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Hello?
People are really more careful in America. How many guns again? Yeah. Fucking hell. It's scary, isn't it? It's scary. It's like I said, I was saying earlier about how hard it is for someone like me to comprehend like what Fortune's about to go through with obviously the hurricane. You know, quite often in the UK, that's all you'll hear people bitching and moaning about is the weather. We really haven't got a fucking clue. You know, it's so fucking cushy over here, really. It really is. Yeah, thanks though, Crimes. I appreciate that, dude. But I like to get myself up and running, mate. It's why I enjoy the game, Crimes. If people just come and bring me everything, it takes away all the fun. It's why I don't play with other people as well, to be honest, mate. I find the game far too easy. As soon as you teamed up with one other person, I just find the game just literally, it's just too easy. And then that's even worse if you've got 2, 3, 4, 5 plus people all living together. I literally got so bored of watching this game on Twitch purely because everyone has these huge communities and the actual streamer just does nothing. I won't mention names because, I mean, you know, that would be very rude of me. But they literally do nothing. Nothing. And then, of course, they can spend all their time chatting away with chat while they just sit here. Like, people will literally bring food to their mouth and feed them. See, I get told off a lot because I can't pay as much attention to chat. That's because I'm actually doing shit. You glad you saw the billing side of things? It's definitely insurance companies. But there are absolutely those clinics, hospitals that cheat the system. Another reason insurance companies stop paying. You're right, Bomber. How you doing, dude? We're hitting all the American big topics, aren't we? Yeah. How's the fresh server going? Very well, actually, Atomic. Yeah, very well, mate. We managed to find the Love Shack again, dude. So this is actually not the same Love Shack from yesterday. It's a whole new one, dude. Yeah, that'd be cool, Crimes. That'd be cool. Yeah, it's very difficult now, Dread, to be honest. They've made some really strange changes in the game. We've played through all the different versions of the alpha this week and last week. So while you've been off, I mean, literally, I think as you went, alpha 15 beta dropped, mate. They've done some things that I really like. They've done some things that I just can't quite get my head around. I'm not a massive fan of the healing changes, as you knew. I think maybe you'd seen that, actually, hadn't you? It's swings and roundabouts right now. The sort of verdict's still out a little bit, I think, to be fair, dude. We don't want these bullet casings, do we? I'm just a bit pissed about food at the moment. We are not doing well on the food front. What's I bringing up here? I think what I'll do today is just try and get try and get the start of the perimeter wall up. Oh, no, I wasn't referring you were blind. I'm just saying that, you know, I mean, I'm sure anyone that's played this game just knows how instantly easy the game becomes if you're, if you're working in teams. I'm not saying, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that the game's not supposed to be played like that. I've played in big communities, you know, certainly back in Alpha 7 where a lot of us met. I really enjoyed it. It's just that right now with a brand new alpha for Definite, I'm all for the lone grubbing it right now, to be honest. I like setting up my own little base. It's fun. Makes me chill out. I know what I'm doing. I know where my boxes are. I'm my own man. What's that, Dredd? You feel like you've missed a bit of a shitstorm. What do you mean, dude? Get these windows sorted. You right, Red Dragon? How you doing, dude? Yeah, you'll be coming back. I mean, if you're coming back to this game, Dredd. Oh, Dredd, are you playing at Mafia 3? I'm trying to find... I've got in touch with a couple of streamers that I watch. Trying to find out who's actually going to be streaming Mafia 3. Because obviously I don't want to be jumping from different channel to channel. I want to watch someone actually play through it. So, or at least the first sort of 10 or so hours. I just can't see me getting a chance to pick it up, to be honest, Dredd. So, I don't want to ruin the whole plot, but I really would like to see, you know, how... I'm a big fan of the series, so I do want to see if anybody I know is going to be streaming it. In fact, that goes out to anyone in chat. If anyone's looking at streaming Mafia 3, please let me know. You're right, Kratos. Electric Boogaloo. See, the power of the internet. Look, it's like, oh, fucking hell, you live next door to me, bro. Oh, are you? Oh, I'll have to come and watch you play it then, Dread. That's awesome, mate. Nice one, Geezer. Yeah, I'm a big fan, dude. I just want to watch someone that's going to sort of, you know, enjoy the game. I don't want someone that's just going to rate. You know, like on YouTube, they just do playthroughs and it's just, they don't do any exploration or like just genuinely enjoying the game. It's like, to them, I don't mean it horribly, but I think to a lot of YouTubers, you know, there's a huge amount of games coming out, and when they do the playthroughs, they're just trying to get through the core content. You know, that's where the views come from, and you know, then they're on to the next game. So I just want to see, you know, watch someone that's chilled out, who watches it, enjoys the game, is going to go out of their way to do a bit of free roaming, as well as doing the core actual single player campaign and all the rest of it. We don't need to knock his window out this time now, do we? Excuse me. Yeah, to be honest, Dredd, I would. If I was going to be playing it, mate, I would be drawing it out like a mofo. I'm really itching to play like some big open world games. I've just started streaming a Red Dead Redemption, Dredd, of an evening. To be honest, it's not got off to a great start this week. I've just been so busy again. And it's weird, I was expecting to have quite a quiet week on the evenings. So we've only got one session in 2 hours. I'm just going to take my time with it, mate. So that's another reason why I won't be picking up Mafia 3, to be fair. Not to mention, obviously, it's going to be it's going to be like 30, 40 quid, isn't it? I think, is it 34 quid on Steam? $34.99? So, you know, it's not a cheap game, is it? Red Dead Redemption I can play for nowt, so... Oh! Damn it! I thought I'd placed it on the counter. It was actually the next one. Damn it. Hang on, have we got a claw hammer here? Let me just throw a light up there so I can see what the fuck's going on. Actually, aren't these claw hammers quite good at smashing things now? You've never played Red Dead Redemption? Oh, Dread, seriously, mate. It's probably my favorite. People always ask you what your favorite game is. Red Dead Redemption is invariably my answer. Skyrim is probably closer to the truth, but that's not fair. It's not a fair comparison. Because every time I play Skyrim, I play a different game. You know, I mod it to hell and back. So it really is completely unfair, really to try and, you know... You know, for me, which is my favourite game? It's still probably going to be Red Dead, but I would play Skyrim every day throughout the year if I actually could. The only reason I don't play Skyrim fucking pretty much every day is that the game's just not stable enough, and sometimes I get irritated because of that. So everything, I can play like the game for 30 hours without so much as a fucking flicker of a frame drop, and then I can play it with no changes, no additional mods, and get like 15 crashes in 6 hours, you know? So, and that's the problem. That's when I start going, yeah, fuck this, we're gonna go play something else now. it's just too erratic in its performance for me. I can't believe we've not had any zombie activity with me doing this. Smashing windows, campfire going. We're very nearly back to where we were on the server, and we were about to hit day 7, weren't we? So, let's get these bad boys popped back in. There we go. £28, what, for Mafia 3? Oh, fucking hell. Shit. Why did you tell me that, Dread? Keep your mouth shut. Damn it, that puts it in the realms of, oh, really? Damn, dude. And you could probably get 20% off that as well. So you could get it for, like, closer to 20 quid, maybe. 20, 25, maybe. Oh, dude, I was thinking it's got like minimum of 35 quid on Steam or something, I suppose. God damn you, Dread. Oh, dear. I don't mind the chat about guns and things, as long as everyone's enjoying chatting. I'm not going to participate because it would be unfair of me to be even remotely critical about such things. I don't live in the country. I don't know what the facts are. But if at any point people start thinking that the old political stroke religious ban as such is or needs reinforcing, just tell me. Or enforcing rather than reinforcing. I don't like saying that we won't talk about things. It's just that at the same time, I also understand tempers can flare very quickly, can't they? So agree that people will disagree, or we'll just say pack it in there. I say sorry, it's £28 with a discount. That's it. Just tell me it's 50 quid, Dread. Just, you know, type it out. Make me feel better. Put some ceiling lights in. We will. Once I can get the stuff sorted with electrics, mate, I'm really looking forward to it. And don't forget, we still haven't done our little roof area yet, either, have we? We decided we were going to go through the wall, didn't we? I believe they are chicks, and that's why I'm not going to say let's pack it in. I have no reason whatsoever to stop people talking about such things. It's just that, you know, I know everything can be perfectly fine 1 minute, and then one comment will trigger the apocalypse in chat. So as long as everyone's agreeing that not everyone has to share the same opinion, then that's fine by me, mate. Fine by me. Tell us our gun laws. You don't have a gun, mate. If you have a gun in the UK, you're probably a naughty boy. I haven't found anything, Ares. We've hardly done any scavenging yet, mate. You think the door would have gone faster? I think you might be right, actually, mate. Yeah. We were trying to be clever, look. Come round the side. And to be honest, weirdly enough, I actually thought it was a metal. Oh, wait, there is a little bit of metal there. We didn't have a light up here the first time we came, so I kind of just... Oh, that's that. That's my phone, look. Fuck him. Let's get a window in. And I'm back, so you don't have to listen to that. You can't own a gun over here, Yukimo. For all intents and purposes, you cannot own a firearm in the UK. Now, there are obviously exceptions, but they are extremely, and I do mean extremely, few and far between. Your average Joe Bloggs, who does a normal job, cannot get a gun permit. You just ain't getting one, mate. Yeah. Well, as I say that, you could, but fucking Jesus Christ, the hoops you have to jump through. It ain't never going to happen, mate. Yeah. There's no other way to put it, really. You know. Oh, what? They look different. Oh, shit. Hang on. What the fuck? Oh, what the fuck, bro? Hang on. What are these? Whoa. Hang on. What are these? Oh, shit. You couldn't make this shit up, could you? You could not make this shit up. Fucking knob. Oh, Jesus. That's funny. To be honest, what you'll find in the UK is that when it comes to guns, you won't get anyone who's got an Uzi or an AK-47 or some sort of M15 rifle or whatever the fuck they are. What you'll find is a lot of people will have air rifles. You'll find a lot of rural areas will have basic shotguns. And I don't mean sawn-off shotguns. I mean, you know, your normal proper, how can I put it, rural farming shotgun. You'll get those kind of things. I was actually on a jury service once, and there was a guy that had come to collect a debt from a farmer, and the farmer basically fired it was actually an air rifle at him, and he was getting done for attempted manslaughter. It's a fucking total joke, absolute joke. Are these just normal frames? Outer log cabin blocks, do they even exist? Can I make them? What am I looking for, guys, to replace these? What am I after here, guys? Someone help me out. What's that, Dredd? Sorry, handgun licenses are very rare. Oh, hang on, sorry, I've missed a bit of chat here. Even the police don't carry guns. Yeah, I mean, you won't see your average Bobby on the beat won't carry a gun. Obviously, we do have armed response units, and we do have, you know, airports and places like that where you see people. You might see armed police in and around London, some of the bigger cities at times. Remember, you can in the UK, you need a farmer to sign a paper saying you can shoot on his land. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, Reborn. Don't get me wrong, Reborn. I'm not trying to say you can't have it. You can, but you also have to go, you know, you have to have a fully legit gun safe and everything. You can't just go and buy a gun. Sorry, you can't just go and buy a gun from a store, can you? Like you can in America. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, no semi-automatics, pump-action shotguns. Yeah, you're not getting any of that shit. The inside are standard wooden frames. Are they really? Holy fuck, you're right, bro. Thanks, mate. I think I might have just swallowed something terrible. I think something just flew into my mouth. Is it some little beast, some little nasty fucking zombie virus fly or something? It's gurgling away, mate. It's gurgling. Right, there you go. Look, let's pretend that little section. That's another bit to cut out, please, Simpsy. Actually, I've just done that. Why don't we go and do these doors as well? Look. Oh, yeah, look at that bad boy. Oh, you're not getting in there now, mate. We'll put a sign up over there as I was telling me which way out it is. Should we put the bedroll in here? I seem to recall knocking this bed out, didn't we? Put the bedroll in, which just made it a little bit safer. Although, having said that, I mean, fucking hell, if they get up here, we're fucking anyway, aren't we? Yeah, let's leave. Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. I don't know what that's all about. I really wish you could have shutters on windows that were animated. That'd be great. Imagine coming back to your base at night and closing all your shutters up. That would just be so cool. Did you like that, Simpsy, when I yeah. He goes through the fucking wall and promptly shores it up behind him. Has to go back through the door anyway. Cobblestone blocks, we need those. So how am I going to make cobblestone today? We are so far behind, aren't we, guys? Cobblestone, cobblestone, cobblestone. Lumps of clay and small stone. Well, I have got a shovel. Should we go and get some clay? Clay, 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 clay. Where should we go? Over there. You know me, Yakumo. I wouldn't just stick a double door there, mate. That's the kind of thing that would drive me mad for months to come. I'd have to rebuild the whole log cabin if I took a shortcut like that. Get rid of the stone. Yeah, we will once we've... I think we need some springs for the king-size bed, Jan. We'll definitely replace it once we... It's horrible. I don't know what that was. It felt like something had just like suddenly launched itself down my throat. It's one of them flying slugs. That's what it was. I'm going to have horrible demon flies crawling out of every... 10 grunt bombs to Yakumo for the extreme imagination. What the fuck are you smoking? You've been coughing your ass off, been sick for that. Oh, sorry to hear that, bits. That sucks, mate. Did you build the house? No, not at all, mate. It's just one of the prefabs. It's the little love shack.
Hello?
Oh, what happened then? You just got cock blocked, Simpsy. You're right, 524. Thank you very much for the follow, mate. How you doing, dude? So, I suppose from today, we can safely say that Alpha
15 might not be working properly because I have not seen any nitrate from those blocks. So why is that?
Grum, fix your mic. Oh, you're echoing. Time to hit the magic switch.
Wonder why that's happened. That's happened twice today now. Sometimes we go like weeks without that happening. I really don't get that. Oh, I just saw a piggy. A piggy McPiggy. Go and see if we can get him. Where you going, little fella? Oh, not really. Where the fuck's he gone? Where did he go? Was he not dead? Piggy! Did I get turned around? Oh no! Hello? I lost me bacon, man! That is shocking, dude. That is shocking. God damn it. That is really, really heartbreaking. Nice little shot on the piggy's backside. Oh, fuck. Dudes, it's that time. I need to go. Possibly. Do you use the USB-A? I do, yes. I do, yes. Why? Do you know about a problem with it, dude? Every now and again, we get that, like, I don't know, because I've never really heard it, but I think people have described it as, like, an echoey kind of thing. When you fix it, you're basically unplugging it and plugging it back in again. No, I'm just going to OBS and telling it to reset the microphone. I mute it on OBS. Go to the OBS audio settings and just tell it to, is it reinitialize? I think it is. Right, boys and girls, I do apologize. I do have to go. And of course, that also means that the server will be going down until the same time tomorrow until we hit day 49. So obviously my thanks to everyone that's joined me today on the server. One of the beauties of playing on the server is I can come and have a look at all your builds and things. So, I'm going to try to be back on around the same time tomorrow, which is about 10 o'clock in the UK, which, as a point of reference, was 5 hours ago now. And we'll obviously... I might not do Red Dead Redemption on Friday night. If I can stream Friday night, we might carry on with this, because I am enjoying it immensely. It's to do with the timing circuit. Oh, fuck. We need to speak about that then, Dread. Is it something I can fix, mate, or what? I just legit don't know. Oh, that's me fanning about. Oh, God, Grum, what are you doing, dude? Let's give you all your Grum bombs before I shoot off. A massive, massive thank you to everyone that's joined me today, as always. But like I said, we'll be back on tomorrow. We might try and get the Red Dead Redemption stream in later this evening. Nice to see you again, Dread. I hope everyone in America who's even remotely close to the goddamn Hurricane Michael is all right. Thoughts are going out to you all, especially to Fortune. Our resident moderator is very close to the epicenter as such. I just want to say a big thank you to MTC as well for today's donation. That was awesome, mate. Hugely, hugely appreciated. I will see you all soon. Have a top evening. Take care.
Hello?